But when I looked at justice, there had been 3,000 recommendations made, 33 commissions on how to improve the justice system. And yet we were still filling up the prisons. Why? I asked myself, and I thought, well, maybe there's too many recommendations. What we need is action. So I said to my colleagues, because in the Saskatchewan justice reform, there were only 8 recommendations with 4 sub titles below each one, which is really only 32. But within 2 weeks, I had an immediate response from the Premier and Cabinet. They were going to implement those 8. So I convinced my colleagues that we don't need recommendations anymore, because there's thousands of recommendations sitting in Ottawa gathering dust. Let's call for action. And not too many. Let's make themes. I had 8 themes, and then came up with 94 calls to action, one of which was to call on the Pope to come to Canada, to apologize directly to the survivors, their families, and their communities for the role of the Catholic Church in the residential school history. Because the other faith group leaders had all apologized. But in Canada, when you come Winnipeg West, we had the highest number of residential schools. Alberta had the highest number in Canada of residential schools. Birthdays were never celebrated in residential schools. So we started having birthday songs and birthday parties and doing our national events across Canada. Little did I know, I was going to get a call from President Bach of the International Olympic Committee while I was in Rome to come to Lausanne and have lunch with him. So I had lunch with him, and he told me he wanted to bring the Olympics back to Canada. So they're going to be for 2030, a bid put in by a group, but he wants it indigenous, not indigenous-led, indigenous-driven Olympics in 2030 in Vancouver. And talked about why I was having to rush back to the Vatican. And he said, hey, Willie, by the way, before you leave, tell the Pope, we're buddies, you know, he said. Tell him, I said hi, give him my best regards, and tell him I support you. So, of course, we talk about all these very serious, tragic issues of situation of women and girls. A calls to action, the 10 principles of reconciliation, and it was time for sports. I told him I was just in Lausanne yesterday, and His Excellency President Box sends his greetings. And he had a smile on his face right away, because he's a real diehard soccer fan, and I knew that. So, we talked about sports, of course. I couldn't even let the moment go by without asking him to encourage our youth to make a choice for positive options, which to us in sports, physical activity, and knowing that he was a good soccer fan. When he responded to us, by the way, the Pope only gives at the maximum half an hour to any delegation. Could be a prime minister, ambassador, a leader of the world, whatever. Well, he gave the Inuit 1 hour. He gave gave the Métis 1 hour. He gave us 1 hour that strips to 2 hours. And then when he responded, he took an hour. So we had 5 hours with the Pope, when normally he only gives half an hour to anyone. So when he came, he talked about his own personal disgust at what he heard, the stories that he heard, and made a commitment that he will come to Canada. He made that commitment. And then as he was leaving the room, he waved, "Bye-bye, I'll see you on your land." And when he said that, I thought, he said, "How strange." I said, "Well, that's strange," when he said, "I'll see you on your land." So little did I know he was going to take Muscatine. It could be the first place he's going to come. So it's a real blessing for us. It's not a political event, although some are trying to make it a political event already. It's about spirituality, it's about healing, and it's about reconciliation. That's what this journey is about. And in 2008, was the first time I thought about doing this. And it was funny because it was in Washington, D.C., at a baseball stadium where he came, the previous Pope came. And I didn't have a ticket. They were selling tickets. We don't even sell tickets here, but they were selling tickets. And I was going down there. I couldn't get a room for the longest time. Finally, I got a room at a hotel. And I went early to the baseball stadium, and I was going to buy a ticket. And I was told they were sold out. And this woman was walking along the line, a big, long, long, long line. And he was coming asking people if they needed to get me the ticket. And he came to me, and she said, "You need a ticket?" I said, "Yes, how much is it?" She said, "Well, unfortunately, my white husband couldn't make it this morning, so here, it's free." And she gave it to me, and I looked at it. It was right beside the altar where the Pope was sitting in Mass. So one thing after another happened. Victor phoned me one night, and he said, "I'm going to the Vatican to the beatification of Saint Catherine, the Mohawk people say Tegakwita, some others say Tekakwita." And he came up with a word in Cree that means, it's very close to it. The Mohawk term is, Cree is very close to it. He said Tekakwita. Tekakwita means tell the truth, tell it in a good way. So a theme here on the 25th, it's going to be about truth. And it's kind of all these coincidental, I think they're just, that's been decided for us way in advance what is going to happen, what is supposed to happen. So it's going to take so much of your time, but I look forward to Monday, because he chose the first place to come was to Muscatine, and then he will go to Edmonton, and then he'll go to Lake St. Anne, and then he'll go to Quebec City, and then he'll go to Lake Calowet, and then back. Because he's 86 years old, he's in a wheelchair now, not in the best of health. His knees are, maybe from his old soccer days, his knees have been really bad. He can't really, not very mobile, so. But we're just about, those of you who have seen the site, you're just about ready. I have Tribal Truth and Reconciliation teepees that I'm gonna have to, as soon as I leave here, go get it so that it can be put up at the former site of the school itself as well. I don't know what he's gonna say. I really don't. I know what I'm gonna say, but I don't know what he's gonna say. He didn't cover all the things that we asked him to talk about when we were in Rome in March. He didn't cover the murdered and missing Indigenous women and girls, like I asked him to support the calls for justice. He didn't cover the papal bulls, the doctrine of discovery, and also the terra nullius. But I'm hoping he was saving those for here. And I hope he talks about them tomorrow, not tomorrow, the day after. Maybe he was saving them for here, I don't know, it's my guess. Only my guess. So, it's been a long journey, a long walk to Rome, I say. But who would have thought that he would say, yes, I'll come. And who would have thought I've chosen Muscatese to be the first to say, because there was a delegation from Rome that went around across Canada looking at sites. And there was a lot of lobbying done by different people. We didn't lobby, we just prayed. So he'll be here. He'll be here. And he'll want to listen to survivors. He wants to be close to us, as he said. Because as you know, he was as a priest, he worked in the slums in Argentina. He lived there, deep in the slums. And when I went to his first mass, that's another quick story. Sorry I've taken so long, but for the first time ever in Calgary, the First Nations, Métis, and Inuit graduates of grade 12 were all having, when you graduate, you never graduated, so I don't know the term, when you have a celebration.
Convocation?
Convocation, thank you. The first convocation ever among the three First Nations, Métis, and Inuit. So they asked me to speak, so I went. And a young man was asked to say a prayer to open the event. And he said, let's pray for the cardinals who are going to be choosing a new pope tomorrow. At night, because of the $8 difference. Will be a new pope tomorrow, so let's pray for them. And we'll pick we'll make a good choice. So he said his prayer. And then after the convocation, the principal came up to me and asked me to say a closing prayer. I said, sure. And it was all the Catholic schools, mainly. So I said to them, they wanted me to talk about the United Nations as a part of my statement. And I talked about 1 year, there was a theme is picked every year by the UN. And theme 1 year was the theme for peace, international peace. 385 prayers were sent to the UN, and one was to be picked for the theme. And the prayer that was chosen was the peace prayer of St. Francis. And after I finished, I asked the kids to join me in saying that prayer. And when I think about it today, it's really about residential schools. It's really about residential schools and what this visit is about. Because it starts out by saying, Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there's hatred, let me sow love. So the hatred and the negativity that's surrounding our community in some places, we need to replace that with love. Where there's injury, like the residential school injury, where there's injury, pardon. Where there's doubt, faith. Where there's darkness, light. Where there's sadness, joy. And it goes on to say, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive. So it's in giving, like this beautiful orange shirts have a nice new golf court, a golf. This is my Orange Day shirt. It's in giving that we receive. And it's in pardoning that we are part to our pardon. And it's in dying that we are born to eternal life. And the part about pardon, the Pope asked for us to give him pardon when he spoke to us in Rome. So this is that moment of time that we talk about. Forgiveness, the power of forgiveness. And if I get a chance to speak, I want to tell him that. For myself, for those that I represent, we forgive for what happened to us as children. Because I think that would be a nice and a big turn towards reconciliation. How do we have better relationships with each other? How do we restore respectful relationships? Itaski win. Having good relations. So it's not by chance we're here together this morning in Itaski win. It's meant to, it was decided for us to be here together this morning for prayer and Thanksgiving, because that's the missing piece in that journey. We had the apology. We didn't have a chance to forgive. They went to healing. It's important to go to healing. And then justice and then reconciliation. So, thank you for all being here. That's my prayer and wishes, that we have that opportunity to find in the deepest parts of our spirit, because they didn't kill our spirit, as we tried, but to find that courage to be able to forgive. Onehtamatatani, that's what they say in Korean. Onehtamatatani, let's forgive each other. Yeah. That'll be the message I want to do this wholeness. So thank you, all of you, for being here. It's a great day, it's a great morning. It'll be a greater day and a greater morning on the 25th. So, I'm asking now, Dr. Tamhina Almeida. Thank you. Thank you very, very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.